wanted to come on today, just give just praise the Lord and just thank God and just meditate on how faithful God is. And He's so faithful. I just wanted to read from Psalm 94. And I love this. I love this. These verses. I love the whole of the psalm. But the verse I wanted to share was from verse 22 to 23, and just of how God is so faithful and is just so faithful, and how He protects us and keeps us. It's awesome. I just wanted to share this. It says, "But the Lord has become my high tower and defense. Glory to God. And my God, the rock of my refuge." I read that again. "But the Lord has become my high tower and defense. And my God, the rock of my refuge. He has turned back their own wickedness upon them, and will destroy them by means of their own evil. The Lord our God will wipe them out." And just like how God is such a mighty defender. How He defends us and protects us. It's mind-blowing, isn't it? As a child of God, we know this. And it's just so mind-blowing. And I wanted to give thanks to God just for His faithfulness. And just to say how much, you know, I love the Lord. And how I'm so grateful for everything. And just give thanks to the Lord with a heart of gratitude, just for how faithful He is and how He defends us. And I'll read that Psalm 22, verse 22 again. It says, "But the Lord has become my high tower and defense." Glory to God. How awesome. "And my God, the rock of my refuge." The rock of my refuge. Glory to God. The Lord is so faithful. And I just wanted to encourage someone today that no matter what you're going through, no matter what you're facing, remember that the Lord is faithful and keeps every word. Keeps every word. You might be going through the roughest battles of your life, but the Lord, hold on to every word the Lord has given you, because it will come to pass. And He is our refuge. He's our tower. He's our high tower, just like verse 22 says of Psalm 94. "But the Lord has become my high tower and defense. And my God, the rock of my refuge." Praise the Lord. Be encouraged that He is our defense. And He will do what He said He will do. I'm trying to think of that scripture. Proverbs 18. The tip of my tongue. It says the righteous run in and they are safe. Oh, I can't remember. Did I have to have a look? What was it? Proverbs 18. Is it 24? Bear with me. That's it. Here it is. Proverbs 18:10. It says, "The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and is safe and set on high, far above evil." I'll read that again. Praise the Lord. Be encouraged. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs to it and is safe and set on high, far above evil. There's no greater power than the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. There's no one or nothing that can match the Lord. Proverbs 18:10, that was it. So we know, as children of God, we can run to the Lord, who is our strong tower, and we're going to be safe because the Lord says it. So we can run. It says, "The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs to it and is safe and set on high, far above all evil." So when we lock ourselves into the name of the Lord, which we are through the blood of Jesus Christ, when we come into the covenant with the Lord, when we become a child of God, when we repent, when we give our heart to Jesus, and that's the condition of the Lord becoming our high tower and defense, is to come into covenant with the Lord through repentance. Then you invoke that blessing of, okay, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Is my strong tower. You can say, okay, the name of the Lord is my strong tower. Now he's my saviour. I've made him my saviour. I've come into covenant with the Lord Jesus Christ. And I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. So you can say, the righteous run to it and is safe and set on high, far above evil. Because the Lord says our righteousness is filthy rags. But when we become a child of God through repentance, we can say, I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, because we're clothed in the righteousness of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. I just wanted to share this today just to give thanks to God and encourage someone, and to remind you that the Lord is our strong tower, and we can run to him and know that we're safe. Be encouraged that whatever you're going through, the Lord is with you. He's holding your hand. He's holding your hand. And it reminds me of Isaiah 41, where it says, "He will uphold us with his righteous right hand." Bear with me. Isaiah 41, beautiful word of God. It says here. Okay, I'll read from verse 9, halfway down. It says, Isaiah 41, "You are my servant. I have chosen you and not rejected you. Even though you are exiled, do not fear anything, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Be assured, I will help you. I will certainly take hold of you with my righteous right hand, a hand of justice, of power, of victory, of salvation. Indeed, all those who are angry with you will be put to shame and humiliated. Those who strive against you will be as nothing and will perish. You shall search for those who quarrel with you, but you will not find them. Those who war against you will be as nothing at all. For I, the Lord your God, keep hold of your right hand. I am the Lord who says to you, do not fear, I will help you." So he upholds us with his righteous right hand, a hand of justice, of power, of victory, of salvation. So we know that the Lord is holding us up. And when we know the Lord, is holding us up. We can rest assured in his power, in his strength, in his victory, that he will carry us through. Be encouraged. He is going to do it with his power. We can lean on the Lord and know that God is God. Be still and know. Fully recognize that he is God. In Jesus' name, amen. He's going to take you through and strengthen you. And he will bring you through. He's faithful. Hold on. In Jesus' name, amen.